We are starting with Ralph Talmont, who is the ghost in the machine between many, many things here happening, many great things happening here in Warsaw, and many things connected to collaboration. He is the head organizer of TEDxWarsaw, and he will tell us how TEDxWarsaw worked and how it improved the quality of conversations that we are having here in our city. So please help me welcome Ralph Talmont.
Okay, now, about the timing, do I just look at the thing? Okay, g'day. I say g'day because that's actually where I come from. I've spent most of my life in Australia and New Zealand, where the roads are good, bureaucracy you can live with, and weather, well, you know, winter's not really an issue. So a few years ago, I find myself here, thanks to a stroke of luck, not far enough north to have polar bears, not far enough east to be in Siberia, but, you know, coming from Australia, the difference is not really that great. However, Poland has a secret, and I knew the secret. You know the secret? This place has the world's most beautiful women. This is a good thing, because thanks to one such woman, I decided, well, I'll stay. Evidently, I wasn't too unhappy about it, because a month later I was ring shopping, and 4 months later we were married. Life was actually looking pretty blissful, except, I had a problem. And there's a graphic of the problem. This is not a distribution of SARS cases. This is a distribution of people I knew before I came here. I think you can spot the problem. You'll probably agree that it's difficult to get anything done unless you know people. Luckily, just at that time, Ted decided to help me out. Just for me, just so I could meet excellent, excellent people. They decided to open up the TEDx program, which of course I embraced wholeheartedly. So, we are now 3 years into it. We're working on our third event. You might say that I have actually been fortunate in being able to meet quite a lot of amazing, amazing people. Not just the speakers, not just the attendees, but really everywhere. And this is a graphic of the people that I know now. You can see that the Central European spot has not just appeared, it has exploded. And in the general neighborhood, there are other spots to signify similar significant growth. And here are some of these amazing people. This is about half our team. Some of them you know. And other than being entirely awesome, they have one other thing in common, and they are half my age. Not that I'm particularly old, but they are particularly young. So just as a happy aside, to keep me relevant and cool with all these wonderful young people, my wife recently bought me a pair of Converse sneakers. I've never had a pair of Converse sneakers in my life. I thought I'd share that with you tonight. It's a happy fact. However, there's a serious side to this talk, and this is something I had occasion to write on my blog not too long ago. The post was actually about a very happy occasion, a very positive event involving a lot of bright young people. But the fact remains that we have a very serious problem in this country, and because of the nature of the problem, we don't talk about it very often. And lack of trust actually is an issue that affects everything, from personal relationships to business and politics, especially politics, because, you see, our so-called leaders find it easy to keep us in silos and manage them and play them off against each other. This works for them, not for us. Take a breath. So, what to do? Well, if I can paraphrase the master, Professore Umberto Eco, by creating language, conversation helps create a sense of community and identity. We need spaces for that conversation to happen. I don't have any answers, but I think what we're doing with TEDx is possibly a way forward, and what's happening at events such as this is also adding to the development of a culture of conversation, and conversation is a really good way to get us out of the silos, conversation with people we don't normally meet about things we don't necessarily consider every day. Heated debate, polite chat, anything in between. We try to emulate the spirit of TED, of course, at our little conferences, and I think it's working, because not only do we get to hear amazing things from amazing people, but also we get to talk to a whole range of people who are all different, but they have one thing in common, and they are willing to give the other person time to hear their views and their side of the story. Because, of course, the motto of TED is ideas worth spreading, and worth spreading means worth talking about. So I think what this city, what this country need right now, almost more than anything else, is a space for conversation to happen, conversation with people we don't normally meet about things that matter. And I think it's up to us, the young and the young at heart, because you see, people without cool sneakers are too old and too set in their ways to do anything about it. Thank you very much.